Okay, welcome to video 15, subnetting 15, creating your first subnet. I'm going to take this table that we developed before, although I've changed it just a hair, but I will explain it in a moment, and then we'll actually do a problem using this table, and you'll discover it's very easy. This first row can represent a number of different things. This first row can represent a value. That is to say, if I'm converting from decimal to binary and binary to decimal, these are the numbers I would use, just like we've done in the past. This can also represent the number of hosts I can get if I borrow from any given row. Watch this. If I borrow from this column, I can get 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, 128 possible addresses. All of these added up turns out to be 128. However, of course, I know I lose two addresses. So if I'm using this row as number of hosts, I always have to subtract 2. So I can get 126, 62, 30, 14, 6, and so forth. Just have to subtract 2. It also happens to represent, and this is kind of a new piece of information, it also happens to represent the increment by which you will need to increase this position as we add up the networks here. It represents the increment you need to add to the previous network address in order to get the next network address. So it's the increment to add a network address in order to get the next network address. Don't worry, this will become clear in a moment. This is the subnet mask. Now remember, we're in the fourth octet. So that means that the subnet mask, since all of this represents the fourth octet, means 255, 255, 255, 128. 255, 255, 255, 192. The CIDR notation for that, 25, in other words, 25 is 255, 255, 255, and then a 1 in the next bit, right? 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. Now, let's use this chart to subnet something. You've been given the network 192.168.1.0. 255, 255, 255, 0. In other words, now I've got 256 addresses to work with here. 255, 255, 255, 0. This is all part of the network. Right here, this is what I can use for host bits, this last octet. You need to make two subnets with at least 50 hosts per subnet. All right, we're going to make two subnets. So let's go ahead and put subnet 1 and subnet 2. Now, we can only do these 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, remember, from our previous video, last two videos. We know the first network address. I'm starting here. I'm starting 192.168.1.0. 192.168.1.0. I also know something else. I know that the first address on this network is going to be the next to the lowest address. 192.168.1.1. Now, I don't yet know the last or the broadcast, so we'll get to that in a moment. Next, let's look at this. I need two subnets. Well, I can get two subnets. Remember, the subnets, I just kind of imagine them right up above here. Two if I borrow one bit, four if I borrow two bits, eight if I borrow three bits. Well, I only need two, so I only need to borrow one bit. This column right here is now going to be our important column. Let's think of it that way. Let's think of it as the column we're going to work with now, or the, I call it sometimes the interesting column here. This column is going to tell us everything we know to fill out the rest of this chart. What is the next network address? I need that in order to get these. What is the next network address? Well, the increments are 128 in the fourth octet. Okay, I'm going to increase this 128 in the fourth octet. 192.168 1.128. Oops, 128. 128 in the fourth octet. This increment from 0 to 128 comes from here, the increment. And we know it's in the fourth octet because we're dealing just with the fourth octet here. Now I can get the rest of this. Watch this. If this is the next network, if this is the second network, then the last address on this network would be one less than that, would it not? 192.168.1.127 is the last address or the broadcast address on the first network. What's the last usable address? The last usable address would be one less than the broadcast address. 192.168.1.126. What is the subnet mask or the CIDR? Well, I could either give it this way or I could give it this way. I could say 255, 255, 255, 128. Or I could just say it's a slash 25. Either one of these will be a correct answer. Well, I still need to know some other stuff here. Well, we know that the if I added a 128 to this, let's say that down here I tried to add 128 to 128. What did I get? 256. Well, 256, of course, I can't make a 192.168.1.256 because that's outside of the, that's not even a valid IP address. But since it is 256, it tells me this, that the broadcast address is 192.168.1.255. The last usable address would be one prior to that. I'm pointing at the screen here, and you can't see me pointing at the screen. 192.168.1.254, and the first address on that network is 192.168.1. Well, what's the next one after 128? 129. I don't need this. And again, our subnet mask or CIDR notation, 255, 255, 255, 128, or slash 25. We can say it either way. Let's see if I can, get that up there. I now have subnetted this into two subnets, and I can get the first address, the last address, the broadcast address, the network address. Notice here, the broadcast address does not end in 255 in this case, and the network address does not start with zero in this case. This is why earlier, when we were doing network and broadcast address, I said, well, for now, zero and 255 are always the network and broadcast addresses. But now that's going to change as we begin subnetting. So this is our first example of how to subnet. Using this table will become, is my favorite way to do it to get started. Later on, as we get practiced at this, we're going to be able to do it without this table. But you notice I did something interesting here. I'm going to go back to shapes here. And I said, once I identify which column I'm going to work in, and I identify what octet I'm dealing with, fourth octet, all of this just becomes very clear. I'm going to increment the fourth octet, which I did. I incremented the fourth octet in order to get my networks. I'm going to put this in the fourth octet in order to get the subnet, the subnet masks. Or I'm going to put a slash 25 if I wanted to give it in CIDR in the fourth. It doesn't matter which octet I'm in this case, but 25 is the fourth octet. So all I did was kind of like a multiplication table. I identified what column I need to work with. And how did I get that? Two subnets, right? I can get two subnets, four subnets, 8, 16, 32, and so on. So once I identified this column, everything else from this chart built off of what's in that column. It's that simple. All right, let's stop this video, and in the next video I'm just going to do some samples and we'll just try a few of these out and see what they look like.